My name is Brayan Ramirez. I am 18 years old, and I am coming from Lion's Den Dojo. What drew me into MMA is that martial arts has always been a part of my life. I did Taekwondo for a couple years when I was really young, and then got into some Ishinryu karate. And then that, I guess, is what led me into doing this MMA stuff, and I love it. My expectations going into this debut fight is I'm pretty excited. I'm a little nervous because this is my first fight, but I mean, I'm ready, you know, I'm motivated.
My name is Noah Hunt. I train out of Chattanooga Mixed Martial Arts College, and I'm 20 years old. Honestly, what I do outside the gym is just work and work and work. Work third shift, so it's kind of hard to balance everything and find other things to do. This is my debut fight. It's a kickboxing match. I really hope to do MMA in the future. For me, it's all mental. I love challenging myself physically and mentally. So this is just a challenge, and I'm willing to do whatever I gotta do. Good luck. I hope you've been training.
We're 135 pounds. I haven't seen 135 in a minute.
It's been a bit. Even though both are debuts, you probably have to give the experience factor to Ramirez here, come from a Taekwondo and karate background, probably been around the game a little bit more. And you see these guys typically transition over to kickboxing first, where they're usually pretty smooth just because you're used to it. You've seen striking come at you, and you've also thrown it yourself. So it'll be interesting to see how this one goes.
Spot on. Can't replicate. Punches coming at you, and he's been in it, he's used to it. He's a little bit of the edge, but you never know. Sometimes guys just get it, and they just get it quick, but you are correct. Easy transition. Again, no headgear, going shin guards.
Smart decision.
No headgear so far tonight.
That's what we like to see.
A lot of guys don't like that headgear. It'll slide down, get in their face, just move not the way you want it to when you're having punches and kicks thrown at you.
Yep. All right, Brayan making his way in. Calm, not a lot of emotion,
Straight to his corner.
His opponent making his way to the cage at this time, Noah Hunt.
Noah Hunt making his way. Like I said, both making their fighting debuts.
Repping the Carhartt.
Carhartt. Says he works a lot. That's all he does, work and train.
Noah, who also goes by Thin and Crispy, the longer of these two guys, does not have the experience, but probably the physical advantage goes to him. So we got a pretty even matchup coming into this.
Yeah, noticeable as soon as he walks out. A lot longer, taller. What did you say his name?
Thin
and Crispy. Love it.
Pizza Bros Pizza.
You're not wrong. Oh, boy.
Expect another dogfight here. Both these guys' debuts probably going to want to come out throwing. Both look very confident coming in here.
Especially after hearing what the crowd is seeing in the first five fights.
A lot of expectation.
Absolutely.
Trust me, you feel those as a fighter. You got a lot of good fights going before you. You want to match that pace. Both these guys are motivated to come out here and put on an absolute show.
Love it. Momentum just keep on rolling through the whole night. Not even halfway through, and this card would stack against anything. This has been unreal. Noah's ready, calm as well. Both these guys look relaxed.
We'll show respect before this gets going.
Here we go, kicking us off, Jake Harris.
Ladies and gentlemen, this next kickboxing bout, it's taking place in the 135-pound division and is scheduled for 3 2-minute rounds. This fight is sponsored by Peyton Carli Lynn, set up over here in the corner. Peyton Carli Lynn, thank you so much for all the incredible pre-fight interviews. Peyton creates fight footage. Her passion, her work includes weddings, realtor videos, as well as prom and other photographer sessions. Give it up for Peyton Carli Lynn. Thank you so much.
Second that.
Moving on to the action and introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is making his kickboxing debut this evening and weighed in at 130.6 pounds. He represents Lion's Den Dojo from Athens, Tennessee, Brayan Ramirez. His opponent standing across the cage. This man also making his kickboxing debut this evening and weighing in at 134.4 pounds. He represents Chattanooga Mixed Martial Arts College by way of Fort Payne, Alabama, Noah Hunt. The referee in charge of the action when the cage door closes is Mr. Chandler Goins.
Brayan Ramirez in the blue corner, wearing the black trunks. All right, blue corner, you ready? Noah Hunt in the red corner, wearing the black trunks. And here we go. That length is obvious right out of the gate.
There's a teep up. Looks like he caught him there. Yeah. Looks like Ramirez tried to tough through it at first and then does a smart thing, take a break, recollect yourself.
Yep.
Especially this early on. But Noah Hunt out of Fort Payne, Alabama, looking to bring a little pain of his own.
There we go.
Heyo.
All night, Austin Mallory, ladies and gentlemen. All right, he's ready to go.
Back at it. Oh, strong body kick by Ramirez right out there.
Ooh,
you see the karate.
You do.
Quick kicks. Heavy hand, though. Oh, Noah sends himself right over.
These guys are lightning fast.
They sure are.
Good thing about these 135, they're a little smaller, don't always pack quite as big a punch, but they are quick, and when it lands hard due to that speed. Inside leg kick kind of gets Noah tripped up there.
Another trip, twice to the ground.
Oh, strong tee, forcing stick at range there.
Noah looks pretty fluid, real long.
Nice volume there.
Brayan counters big when he gets inside.
Not scared to close the range there. It's what he's got to do against this long guy.
Just missed with that front kick up the middle.
Ramirez responds with a kick of his own. Ooh. A little switch and roundhouse right there.
Does a good job of getting inside.
Oh, absolutely. Ooh.
Oh, big shots from Noah Hunt.
Pouring it on here.
He sure
Ramirez
is.
Wobbly. Not really keeping his hands up. Maybe a little downside that karate taekwondo background. But snaps back in pretty quick. But he's eating them.
Yeah, still coming
good
forward,
knees,
though.
But he's landing strong body shots.
Straight forward, no guard, just taking shots on his way in. Whatever he can do to get inside.
Strong leg kick there from Ramirez. Followed up by a tee from Hunt. Strong body side as they disengage. Someone's got a little blood on him. Maybe Ramirez come from the nose there. Another cheap up the middle, and those are digging in right under that belly button, and those take a toll.
You saw first round, boys.
Good first round. You saw in the first fight with Valentin. Took a lot of those teeth from Thompson Bailey. Saw him wear down a lot quicker. Goes in there, starts breaking down your diaphragm, makes a lot harder to breathe, and it's more of a war of attrition getting through the fight instead of you putting on the same tempo.
That's right. Yeah, he's doing a good job of landing those right up the middle, trying to keep distance, but give it to Brayan Ramirez. He's just ducking his head and coming forward.
Yep, he's coming
in. Making his way in.
He's not running.
He is not running.
Both these guys landing very strong. I think Hunt got a little bit more of the large shots there, but Ramirez definitely probably poured it on whenever he got the opportunity. So it'll be a fun round to see how it scored.
Yeah, he had him kind of wobble there halfway through the round.
But you can't discount the strong inside leg kicks that led to Hunt falling.
Right.
Very crafty guy. Very even fight so far.
I'm going to give it to Red. We'll see what they say.
Round one goes to the red corner, Mr. Noah Hunt.
There we go.
Got a great prognosticator beside me tonight.
I'll tell you what. calling it right so far. Three for three.
The judges got to put in a little work tonight.
I was going
to
say, there hasn't been that many opportunities.
Got to get them woken up.
It's easy to call fights when somebody just wins, unless they look just like each other, and then that's kind of tricky, but that's okay. Go back at it, round two.
Hunt throwing those early leg kicks to start the round. Usually you see guys open it up with those hands and follow it and end the combo with the big leg kick, but Hunt working the opposite way. Ramirez' nose pouring blood here.
Yep,
you are right.
another strong inside leg kick. He's not backing down at all.
Nope. He's taking a shot though. Hunt's countering almost every time he gets in. Looks like big rights.
Looks like Ramirez maybe trying to work that body break down Hunt. That's why those hands are staying pretty low.
Yeah.
But he's paying for it when he comes in.
Sure is.
Ooh, strong body kick from Hunt.
Counter right from Ramirez. Neither one of these guys are going anywhere. They are.
Nope. No fear.
No running. Speaking of running, we'll be running over to Pizza Bros for the after party after this, guys.
Oh, boy. Cannot wait. Unless we can make something happen on the in between now and then. But that's we'll talk about that later.
See with these kickboxing K1 rules. Quick break out of the clinch. Not letting the boys play a lot there.
That's right.
Hunt landing heavy over the top here, but Ramirez tries to follow with strong body strike, gets his first big ride of the fight.
Both guys slowing down just a tick, making their debuts. That first round, they came out fast, a lot of pressure.
Yeah, that reach definitely all the difference so
far. Sure is.
Makes a lot of difference there. But usually with debuting guys, you'll see one kind of take a few shots, start backing down. Kind of not sure if he wants to be in there, but neither of these guys showing any quit at all. Both pouring it on. Slowing it down this round a little bit, but when they're throwing hard.
Head
Hunt
kick,
caught him with a head
right.
kick.
Yep.
Goes to clinch, kind of reset here.
Great
Another
second
good
round.
Go, boys.
Be our first third round.
Didn't know they went this long.
Yeah.
2 minutes doesn't sound like a long time for these kickboxing fights, but trust me, these are a full sprint. In MMA, you're allowed to kind of grapple against the cage, take a break if you need it, if you're in the more dominant position. But kickboxing, either way, you always got to be on. You always got to be running through these.
Gas pedal the whole time. Both of them appeared to slow just a bit, but both still bringing it. No, Hunt's range is really showing. I think he won that one as well, just with the longer, bigger shots.
They look really fresh in the corners.
Yeah.
They're not really taking huge breaths.
Ramirez is pouring blood out of his nose. You are correct about that.
That's probably telling more why he's breathing hard than his cardio.
That's right.
Definitely makes a huge difference.
All right, here we go.
Round number two goes once again to the red corner, Noah Hunt.
So Ramirez knows he's got to come in. He's got to make something happen in this third round.
That's my favorite thing about this open scoring in Tennessee. If you're down 2-0, you got to come out like a dog, and you got to hunt.
Yep.
Another
hunt,
pun.
Huh?
Pun.
Didn't mean that one, but just I got it.
You're
Nailed
on.
It. When you're just on,
strong
you're
body
on.
Strikes from Ramirez there. Follows up with a leg kick. Hunt not working as far. As I say that, he throws a strong
That's
deep
right.
in the middle, keeping it range. Ramirez circling. Like to see a little bit more volume from these guys, but both very tired, pretty broken down by this point, but they're still throwing hard.
Yeah, Hunt seems to just be kind of circling, knowing he's up 2 rounds to nothing.
The thing with that, you can't coast or stuff like
Something
this.
That happens. That's right.
Yeah, that
Ramirez
a lot of body
strong.
Work.
His coach is calling for leg kicks.
That should. Big kick by Ramirez just misses there.
Still pouring blood.
Spinning back kick. Trying to throw up a little prayer here, maybe. Oh, strong overhand by Ramirez. He's still right in this. But he needs to press a little bit harder if he's going to win this one. Almost a little half. Superman almost responded to by Hunt, but Ramirez with a good head movement.
Constant
strong
left.
Jab. Gets him on the back foot for the first time, really, this fight.
Ramirez
Body
is
shots.
Bringing it. He wants it.
Oh.
Oh, big shot.
Game plan's working here. Hunt's starting to open up.
Yeah, if this was 5 rounds, could be turning a tie
sure
here.
Could be.
Mouth open from Hunt. Don't really love to see that if you're in his corner.
Trying to keep that range.
Good knee right up the middle there. But Mirror's working the body right out. He's kind of pieced it all together here, working the body as soon as those hands drop, going right over the top.
Like the urgency from Ramirez, just bringing it.
Just not landing quite enough here. But still walking down. Up. Kind of put in some work here, landed a few clean up top.
Got some nice combos, body, body, head.
Great third round.
Great third round.
Not going to be quite enough.
Yeah.
Great fight.
Great fight. Both these guys making their debuts, bringing it. Excellent fight. Both guys gave it all there, gassed.
Hudson right in front of us, trying to get his breath back. Good performance by him right on his debut, but taking nothing away from Ramirez. A lot of that here comes from the reach advantage from Hunt. It's hard to get in, even with that karate background. Will be interesting to see if Ramirez moves, tries to make a move to 125 after this one.
Yeah.
Maybe his more natural weight class till he goes transition to MMA, if that's what he's planning for.
Yeah, the reach was the story of this fight.
Yeah.
From Noah Hunt. Credit to Ramirez. Did everything he could to try and get inside. It was just a little bit too much for him. And he brought in that third round. Yeah. Clearly won that third round.
I agree 100%.
Very nice third round.
It's just kind of hard to recover when you get your nose busted like that the first round. Yeah. Hard to breathe, kind of hard to see. Your eyes start pumping up a little bit too. It's what you don't really get. If you break your nose, it's not just your nose that's being affected there. It usually kind of leaks back into those orbitals and really disrupts your whole game plan, your whole fight.
Great fight.
Yep. First decision of the night.
That's right.
If that was a street fight, though, whoever wins at the end
wins.
That's
exactly right. Nate Diaz rules. Here we go to make it official. Ring announcer, Mr. Jake Harris. Here we go.
Ladies and gentlemen, let these guys hear it going the distance all three rounds. Give it up. Heck of a debut by both of these fighters, but ultimately the winner goes to the red corner, Noah Hunt!
I know the first thing I'm doing come Monday is hitting cardio. I was gassed. It was bad. But I want to thank Brian for coming out and fighting. Hell of an opponent. Really tough, especially in that first round. I thought you were going to fall, and you didn't. And you pushed me for three rounds, so I appreciate it. I want to thank Billy and my whole team for coming out here and pushing me and talking to me behind the scenes. And my whole friends and family came out for me. Can't thank everyone enough, so thank you.